There's more to performance braking than throwing the biggest brake kit you can on your vehicle. We're here to talk to Kirk from Tilton about creating a perfectly balanced braking system. So with people starting with a street car or an OEM-based car and they're developing it to a performance application or into a motorsport car, a vehicle, generally an OEM car will come with a tandem master cylinder for the brakes and a brake booster as well. We don't often see that in motorsport vehicles. Can you explain what we do see and why?
Yeah, in motorsport vehicles, we typically have a dual master cylinder setup, which you have one master cylinder for the front brake circuit, one master cylinder for a rear brake circuit with a balance bar that operates both of them. So you're able to achieve better braking balance through sizing the masters appropriately and correctly. And so when we size masters, we look into piston sizes in the caliper, rotor diameter, tire diameter, vehicle weight, weight distribution. That all gets factored in and determine the sizes of masters to start with, and pedal ratio also. Another benefit is you get 95% of your braking balance through the sizing of the masters, but then the balance bar enables you with the remote adjuster to make adjustments to the braking balance on the track. If fuel loads changes, track conditions changes, you want more front or rear brake, you could dial it in with the balance bar to get more bias you want.
So it's really based around tunability. Is there also some benefit to kind of consistency of the brake pedal feel moving to a manual brake system rather than a boosted system?
Yes, it's going to provide better driver feedback for sure. The booster is kind of an artificial, gives more of an artificial feel where this is it's going to be a firmer pedal, give more confidence to the driver on what the brakes are really doing.
So in terms of the manual system that we see in motorsport vehicles with dual master cylinders, sizing those two and then how that's related to the sizing of the calipers, what's the kind of method that you'd work through there with figuring out the sizes to get yourself in a decent starting point before you need to make tuning adjustments from there?
Well, typically we like to see the calipers size where the piston area, the rear caliper is about 50% of the fronts. Sometimes we have customers, choose, they kind of pick maybe the not the best option for calipers. And so if they go say the calipers in the rear are too big, then we got to kind of compensate that for in the master cylinder sizing. And you may see a pretty big spread in the difference between the front and rear master where we try to get them pretty close ideally.
So you want to start with them pretty close just so there's no massive imbalance there that you've got to then
compensate for. Yeah.
Moving from an assisted system, what would be the typical pedal ratio that you'd see on like an OEM vehicle with a brake booster?
Yeah, seeing in modern cars, you're like a 4-to-1 ratio is kind of what a modern car has. And most of the motorsport application, our pedal boxes are anywhere from about 5-to-1 to 6.5-to-1. And of course, that's factored it into the master cylinder size and also what the pedal ratio is.
Yeah, so that extra, that gives you a mechanical advantage to make up for the lack of assistance.
Correct, yes.
Okay, just backing up a little bit to the balance bar. Setting the actual balance bar in the first place before any adjustments are made using the hand control, the dial, what are we looking for there when we're setting it up?
When you set it up, you'll set up the clevises of the balance bar to be on the same center distance of the master cylinder mounting studs. So that you'll set the clevises at that distance. Then you'll thread the push rods of the master cylinders into the clevises equally to kind of set your desired pedal position. And then from there, you usually make the front master cylinder push rod about 1/4 inch longer because you typically use more front brakes, a little more stroke. So you do a little stagger in the setup that way.
And then the hand dial allows the driver to make adjustments from there. And what would they need to kind of make those adjustments for? Changing conditions?
Yeah, changing conditions, fuel load changes. So, next, if they're finding they're locking up their rear brakes, they want to dial that out, they'll put more bias to the front brakes to keep the car more balanced under braking.
So really when speccing the size of the master cylinders, the brake cylinders, the entire braking system, it's really a package that you need to consider the whole thing to work the balance together? Or is there a set kind of way of working through maybe from the caliper size back to the master cylinder size pedal ratio that you can go through?
Yeah, so when customers ask us what sizes to use, the things we ask them is, okay, what what's the piston sizes in your front and rear calipers, rotor diameter, tire diameter, vehicle weight, weight distribution, pedal ratio, and then we factor in a brake pad coefficient, a tire coefficient into our calculation. So we take all that information, put it into a program, and then it predicts what size masters to start with. And then you go to test the vehicle with those size masters. You find it may not be ideal. You may have to make some minor adjustments, but it's a good starting point.
That's it, getting it into a good starting point and then being able to make the finite adjustments from there with the controls.
Yeah, you know, at the end of the day, you know, math could tell you one thing, but you know, real world, you know, track conditions, you may not match up. So you may have to make some adjustments from there after testing.
Right, well, thank you for your time. It's been really interesting. If people want to find out more about your product or potentially purchase anything, where can they go?
They go to tiltonracing.com.
Right, thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.